Kratos can't die. He is cursed to live forever. This is something Corey Barlog has claimed in multiple interviews. However, there haven't really been any clear indications of how he was cursed. Why is Kratos not mortal? Today, I'm going to tell you and explain how Kratos became immortal and why he can't kill himself. But before that, remember to subscribe and hit the like button. If you can get this video up to 100 likes, YouTube will spread my video around and I would really appreciate it. Anyway, let's get right into it. One of the ways we can tell when Kratos is immortal and when he isn't is through his scars. When Kratos is mortal, his injuries form scars, and when he isn't, he simply heals. This is shown in God of War 2 and God of War 4. In God of War 2, Kratos puts all his godly powers into the Blade of Olympus, making himself vulnerable. This is why Zeus was able to kill him and the rest of his army. You might think that Zeus was able to kill Kratos merely because he used the Blade of Olympus, a weapon capable of killing titans, but if that was the case, Zeus wouldn't have tried to trick Kratos into draining his powers into the sword. Otherwise, why would Zeus leave Kratos with such a powerful weapon? Zeus needed to weaken Kratos so he can kill him. There's also evidence to suggest that gods can withstand multiple stabs from the Blade of Olympus. At the end of God of War 2 and God of War 3, Zeus was penetrated with the blade numerous times only to survive and heal. And we see no scars in Zeus because when Zeus was struck by the weapon, he was immortal. For more evidence, in God of War 4, Baldur pierced Kratos in the torso with the end of a big, sharp rock, and afterwards we don't see any scars or proof of the injury at all. Furthermore, we know that the scar on Kratos' face was given to him by Ares when Kratos tried to save his brother. At that point in Kratos' life, he was young and most definitely immortal, and that's why the scar was formed over his eye. We see older Kratos take multiple hits much worse than the one Ares gave him, and later we can see that there are no discernible marks. Kratos regains his godhood when Gaia saves him. And throughout the game, we witness Kratos recover his powers so that by the time he reaches Zeus, he is strong enough to fight him. Further evidence that suggests Kratos regains his godhood after Gaia saves him is exhibited in his interactions with his Spartan warriors.
My lord,
I knew you could not be killed. I never lost faith. But our brothers are dead.
And what of you, my lord?
The warriors still refer to him as a god, and once you become a god, as long as you have worshippers, you remain one. Greek gods cannot lose their godhood unless you destroy the significance their domains hold. For example, if Zeus has to become mortal, his domain, the sky and the lightning, as well as Zeus himself, must hold no significance. That means that when Zeus, the sky, and the lightning are no longer acknowledged and worshipped by the people, only then can Zeus lose his immortality. Similar is the case with Poseidon. For Poseidon, the god of oceans and seas, earthquakes and horses, for him to become mortal, people must no longer acknowledge him and these bodies. In fact, the only god that was said to have truly lost their godhood was Pan, the god of nature, the wild, and the shepherds. Pan is said to have died when people ceased to worship nature and the wild. People stopped worshipping the nature, spirits, the naiads, the nymphs, etc. This is why even though Kratos drained his godly powers into the Blade of Olympus, he was still a god when he was resurrected. Since the Spartan warriors had faith in him after seeing that he was still alive, Kratos became mortal again and a god once more. But how did he become immortal in the first place and die to Zeus if the warriors had faith in him, you might ask? Firstly, do not confuse being a god with dying. The Greek gods in the God of War universe can still die even if they're immortal because their immortality is conditional. Secondly, when Kratos put his godly powers into the Blade of Olympus, he became weak. It is possible that Kratos was still a god, that he was still immortal, just perhaps a weak immortal. When Kratos was crushed by the hand of the Colossus, we can see that the Spartans were beginning to lose hope. To see their god so weak, they started to doubt Kratos, and when Zeus killed everyone on the battlefield, it must have been hard for the surviving warriors to remain hopeful of their god, Kratos.
can this be? Why does our god struggle?
Thus, Kratos could have lost his immortality for a brief moment due to the lack of faith from his people. And that is why his scar formed. So it is possible that Kratos might have never lost his immortality and godhood to Zeus and his trickery. Yes, Kratos lost his godly powers that kept him strong and durable, just not his conditional immortality and godhood. Throughout the game, we see that different gods have different strengths. For example, Hera was easily killed by Kratos, while Hades not so much. It took one stab with the Blade of Olympus to kill Athena, but multiple stabs to kill Zeus. So when Kratos drained his powers, he could have still been a god, just simply a weakened one. He could have only lost his godhood when the Spartans began to lose faith in him. Sure, we were meant to believe that initially Athena made Kratos immortal and gave him the powers and the strength of a god at the end of God of War Ghost of Sparta, but that is not the truth. Kratos became a god at the end of God of War 1, and the Spartans referred to Kratos as a god throughout God of War Ghost of Sparta. Athena made Kratos a god by making him known amongst the people as the new God of War, and not by pushing a glowing green light emitting from her fingers against Kratos' head. At the end of God of War Ghost of Sparta, Athena could have been giving Kratos that extra godly power that enabled him to grow in size and attack the city, but even that little gimmick Athena tried to perform was interrupted by Kratos when he said,
"Is this all a game to you, Athena?"
Kratos became immortal at the end of God of War 1, and never really lost his immortality until he was tricked by Zeus, causing the Spartans to lose hope in him. But as we established, Kratos regains his godhood when the Spartans see that he is still alive. You might then ask why Kratos has no scar from when he was killed in God of War 1 with the sharp rock arrows threw at him from halfway across the globe. This is because in God of War 1, Kratos actually died. And when Kratos came back from the underworld, he was in a new body. Perhaps a body that was gifted to Kratos by Zeus. Because unlike God of War 2 and 3, where Kratos' body was taken to the underworld, in God of War 1, Kratos' soul was taken to the underworld, not his body.
In death, he had failed. As the minions of Ares claimed Pandora's box, Kratos' life faded, and his cursed soul was cast into the fires of Hades.
So when the Gravedigger, or Zeus in disguise, pulled Kratos up from the underground back when Kratos and Zeus were on good terms, Zeus could have given Kratos a new body. Or perhaps Zeus healed Kratos' body and gave it back to him. And since Zeus' regenerating abilities are probably better than Gaia's, it would make sense why there is no scar on Kratos' torso. But I like to believe that Zeus gave Kratos a new body, and back in Pandora's temple lies the remains of Kratos' old body. After all, we saw Ares use soulless copies of Kratos' body to fight Kratos and his family, so Zeus giving Kratos an identical copy of Kratos' body is not that far-fetched. But then, how is Kratos still a god in God of War 4? Are there still people worshipping Kratos? Possibly. After all, Kratos released the power of hope to the people, and we see the vases and other sculptures with paintings of Kratos on them. Even Mimir immediately recognized Kratos when Mimir found out that Kratos was a son of Zeus. And notice what Kratos refers to being a god as.
It is a curse. Her boy has been cursed.
Kratos says that being a god is a curse. So, when Cory Barlog says that Kratos is cursed to walk the earth forever, he could be referring to the same thing Kratos is. The fact that Kratos is a god, an immortal god.
You said I was cursed. You think I'm weak because I'm not like you. I know I was never what you wanted. But after all this, I thought maybe things were different.
You do not know everything, boy.
No. But at least I know the truth now.
The truth. The truth. I am a god, boy. From another land far from here. When I came to these shores, I chose to live as a man. But the truth is, I was born a god, and so were you.
But wait, Kratos' immortality is not conditional. Kratos simply cannot die. He is cursed to live forever. Why can't Kratos kill himself? Perhaps Kratos has reached a level of godhood that is simply unkillable. Perhaps death cannot catch up with Kratos' regenerating abilities or godly powers. Just like it took multiple stabs to kill Zeus, Kratos might need more, I don't know, 1,000 stabs from the Blade of Olympus to die. Or he simply could actually be cursed. But by who? Well, ladies and gentlemen, it was the village oracle. Listen to what she says.
From this night forward, the mark of your terrible deed will be visible to all. The ashes of your wife and child will remain fastened to your skin, never to be removed.
And with that curse, all would know him for the beast he had become. His skin white with the ash of his dead family. The ghost of Sparta had been born.
She says that the ashes are never to be removed from his skin. This is why Kratos cannot be killed, at least not for long. Because if Kratos dies, his skin decomposes, and if his skin decomposes, it would liquefy and the ashes fastened to his skin would be removed. For the curse to remain true, Kratos must always have skin, and for him to always have skin, he must live forever and he must be alive for all to see. If Kratos dies, the ashes on his skin are eventually removed, even in the underworld. We see this happen in God of War Chains of Olympus. When Kratos tries to enter Elysium, the ashes on his skin were removed, and I'm sure if Kratos stayed in the River Styx long enough, his ashes would have been removed there as well. So the ashes are fixed to Kratos for eternity, and therefore he cannot truly die. Or if he does, he would have to come back to life to keep the curse loyal. Well, why can't we just kill Kratos and freeze him as they did to Ares in God of War 3, so that way the ashes are still fixed to his skin? Again, then the curse would be broken because Kratos' skin wouldn't be white for all to see. The cold would turn Kratos' skin blue and even black in some areas. It would also be hard for all to see Kratos' white skin under the ice. Ice is not as transparent as you might think. The only other thing that I need to mention is that even though the village oracle curses Kratos so that the ashes of his family are never to be removed from his skin, we saw the ashes come off Kratos at the gate of Elysium. The only explanation is that the ashes weren't actually removed from Kratos' skin at that time, but he was just actually transformed into a soul, a pure soul to enter Elysium. Kratos' real body, with the ash white skin, must have been left out of the realm and only returned to him when he killed the other souls in the field. The fact that the ashes on Kratos' skin would disappear or become unrecognizable after his death still stands. And if that happens, then the curse is broken. And that cannot be. Therefore, Kratos is immortal. Anyway, that's all I have to mention for today. Don't forget that this is just a theory, and everything I just said could be baloney, but I think it makes sense. Like and subscribe.